and this is a proposal that we've been working for over 6 months now. We've drawn it back, we've put it off, we've amended it, we've talked to council members individually, we've talked to them collectively. You know, we did all that we thought we could do. We've introduced to them new cuts. We have changed things in terms of procedures and regulations within the city. And we still were not able to get them to vote for it. There was some urgency to it because of our serious capital projects. We have some real emergencies in capital as it relates to garbage trucks, as it relates to fire trucks, as it relates to police cars. And we got some critical infrastructure needs that are emergency needs. We were real concerned about that. That really kind of takes that off the table for us. So we are going to have some issues, some real issues.
Where we go from here?
Well, where we are right now is we have to operate based on what we have. And that won't be business as usual. We're going to miss some things. And as we go into the next year, as of right now, we have a $29 million deficit. And what we do is when we present the proposed budget to the council in July, we propose a budget with $29 million cut out of it. And then it's in the council's lap. They have to deal with the budget at that point. So as far as I'm concerned, we have submitted every proposal we can submit. So now I'm waiting on the council to submit me something that they think will solve the city's problem. I've not seen that yet. During this whole 6 month period, I'm anxious to see that. When that comes about, we are perfectly willing to work with it if it's something that's workable. So that's really kind of where we are. But it's real critical to our city. Because what it does is, we don't have 6 months to waste. We don't have that kind of time to waste. We have so many things going on right now. We have so many projects we're trying to work. We have so many issues we're trying to address. And we're 6 months behind on them already. So I would suspect that if we don't get them done in the next month, we'll wind up being almost a year behind on them, which will hurt the city as a whole, which will hurt the image of the city, and I think eventually will be a real negative for Mobile.
Sam, I realize it's a moot point at this point, but what was your reaction to what the committee had?
I thought the committee worked hard. I thought they did a good job. They met with us a couple of times. They asked for information. We gave them information. They had some very, very good questions. I think the committee was really dedicated to finding a solution. I would think that they're somewhat frustrated today after going through all of that and getting no further than we were 6 months ago.
Are you considering any other kind of sales tax proposal, whether it's half a penny or doing another penny?
Well, as you know, we propose a lot of different things, and they've all been rejected to this point. So maybe the council has something else in mind that we haven't considered. We've asked them that in the past, but we didn't get anything as a result of that. So if they do have something, and it's something that we think is positive and move the city forward, I can assure you our decision-making process won't be near this long. Our decision-making process could be done in a day. The problem is that we have to get something that we could put in place prior to budget preparation. And we start budget preparation in June. So we can have it finished in July. The law say I have to have it to them by law on August 20th. We want to try to give them 30-day lead time because of what's happening here. So I want to try to get it to them July 15th.